regardless of age, health status, anything else, sex, everything. This process is, it's there because of the DNA, and everybody's got DNA. The only special population, which is what I'm trying to say here today, is the only special population is a creature from a different phylum, like a reptile.
I think to this,
or actually, that's not, that's the same phylum actually.
I think
a jellyfish.
It's been
do jellyfish respond to stress, adaptation, regret?
I'm sure they do. Or
well, you know.
It's been a while, but I think I don't imagine they've changed this. But the ACSM considers women a special population. It's not a fucking special population.
Yeah. The ACSM is wrong about virtually everything.
A special population would maybe could be like an elderly, frail person, but even then, it's not. It's
the
not.
The process is exactly the same.
Yeah. It, or somebody with it.
The process is the same. The difference is a matter of degree. That's all there is to it. This is stress, recovery, adaptation. Do I take a 48-year-old lady and bring her in the gym and have her squat 135 the first time and then go up to 145 the following workout? No. No, because that would be stupid. But I do have her go up to maybe 65 pounds the first day. And then when I bring her back in the gym 2 days later, I might go up to 70 pounds. I might go up to 67 and a half. But I'll have her do sets of five. And after she squats, I'll have her press or bench press, following the same basic rules, and then I'll have her deadlift. And guess what happens when she deadlifts? She's going to deadlift way more than she squats, because everybody can deadlift when they start. Everybody can deadlift way more than they squat. I've trained women that couldn't squat their body weight on the first day, but could deadlift 110 pounds on the first day, because the difference in the two movement patterns. We take advantage of that, and we load optimally. But optimal loading is different for everybody. So does that mean that everybody is in a special population? No, it means everybody is in the same population. But the rules apply. Even though they were drawn from working with young men with a whole bunch of testosterone and a whole bunch of growth potential, the rules, as it turns out, applies to everybody in the species.
You touched on the psychological and women coming in there not knowing what they're capable of,
right?
Specifically older women not knowing what they're capable of. Penny, who's what, early 80s,
yeah,
came in. We were deadlifting, we were adding weight to the bar every time, and she came up to me after maybe a month and said, Rusty, I want to hit, and this is the beginning of this year, Rusty, I want to hit the goal of deadlifting 100 pounds before the year is over. And I laughed at her and said, Penny, you're going to be repping that before the month is over. And what did we do last time she was in there? 3x3 of 100 pounds in her mid-80s, and she has never deadlifted before. Well, I mean, you know, before she started training with me.
Right.
But, I mean, that just tells you, this special population thing, again, we can label special populations all we want. It's working for anybody.
I talked to my friend Ellen Stein on the phone the other day. Now, Ellen is 71, and I had some input into her squat several years ago, and she took my advice on that. She is, in terms of her age and her weight classes, she's been 132 for a very long time. Ellen is squatting in the high 300s.
Oh, yeah, you showed me her.
She's benching in the 140s. She deadlifts a little over 400 at the age of 71.
Yeah.
More importantly, with a grade 3 spondylolisthesis, which is stable because she is strong. All right, now, join us this week for Starting Strength Radio. After we dispose of the comments from the haters, we get into the meat of an interesting discussion about strength and how to train what are referred to as special populations. What we're going to show you is that there's no such thing as a special population. Friday, Starting Strength Radio.